In this video, we will mainly discuss about acceleration and few other important points to be noted. So let's get started. In the previous video, we have discussed about displacement and then velocity, which is nothing but the rate of change of displacement. And now acceleration is nothing but the rate of change of velocity, which is given by delta v by delta t. Since velocity is a vector quantity, so change in velocity is also a vector quantity. So acceleration has a direction and it will be same as that of change in velocity. In order to explain this, consider an example of a car which has zero velocity initially. And after 1 minute, let's say the car has reached a velocity of 5 meter per second. So the acceleration is equal to the change in velocity divided by change in time. After the unit conversion, it is equal to 1 by 12 meter per second square, which means for every second, the car velocity is increasing by 1 by 12 meter per second. Since the velocity of the car is increasing along the positive x-axis, so the acceleration direction will be along positive x-axis. We can get the acceleration direction by using the vector method. Since the velocity of the car is along the positive x-axis, so v1 equal to 0 I cap and v2 equal to 5 I cap. So we can find the acceleration to be 1 by 12 I cap meter per second square, which shows the direction of acceleration is along I cap, which is positive x-axis. Now let's consider a case in which object is moving along a curved path and consider the velocity change in a small duration of time, that is delta t. So the acceleration is given by delta v by delta t, which is equals to v2 minus v1 by t2 minus t1. This acceleration gives the average value in the time delta t. So in order to find the direction of acceleration, we have to use vector subtraction. We can find the instantaneous acceleration by using the formula a equal to dv by dt. And if the magnitude of velocity is constant, then the acceleration will be only because of the change in direction of the velocity. And in such cases of uniform velocity, the acceleration will be directed along the normal to the curve. Now let's consider an example of a 2D motion, where object has a velocity of 3 I cap plus 4 J cap meter per second at t equal to 0 seconds and 5 I cap plus 6 J cap after 1 second. Then the acceleration can be calculated to be 2 I cap plus 2 J cap meter per second square. Since this is a vector, it has both magnitude and direction. So in order to find the magnitude of the acceleration, find the square root of the sum of the squares of components of acceleration, which gives 2 root 2 meter per second square. And in order to find the direction, we will use the unit vector. So in order to find the unit vector, the acceleration vector should be divided by its magnitude, which results in I cap by root 2 plus J cap by root 2. Now this can be graphically represented like this. And the angle made with the x-axis can be found out to be 45 degrees from the unit vector. So please take a look at the summary and the practice problems. Please post the answer or any suggestions you have in the comment box. And if you enjoy the video, please do like, share and subscribe.